Did you know, diasporically, that the first black Catholic saint was an Afro-Peruvian with an Afro-Panamanian mother?
San Martin de Porres Velázquez was an Afro-Peruvian lay brother of the Dominican order and the first Afro-descendant Catholic saint in Latin America. He is the patron saint of mixed ancestry people, barbers, innkeepers, and public health workers. He was beatified in 1837 and canonized in 1962. He was said to possess miraculous healing powers and the ability to communicate with animals, most likely an interpretation of the subjugation, positioning him akin to that of animals that he endured in the Catholic Church. San Martin de Porres is often depicted with a broom as a symbol of his humility, highlighting his subordination under the white supremacist social hierarchy in Peruvian society and in the church. Born on December 9, 1579 in Lima, Peru, the son of a Spanish father and a formerly enslaved Afro-Panamanian mother, de Porres' father abandoned his mother to raise him and his sister in poverty. When his mother was no longer able to, San Martin left home for a barber surgeon apprenticeship. At 15, de Porres began volunteering in the monastery of the Dominicans of the Holy Rosary, performing menial tasks in exchange for lodgings. As an Afro-descendant, caste laws forbade him from becoming a full member of a religious order. He was not to ascend past the station of church custodian. He suffered racial harassment during his earlier years in the monastery. He was often mocked for being the illegitimate mulatto child of a formerly enslaved mother. He even internalized such abuse, referring to himself as a mulatto dog and volunteering to be sold when the church faced financial problems. His revered humility and admiration for his role in an imaginary racial harmony was such as it did not disrupt or attempt to subvert the social order of the day. De Porres took up his prescribed role. His subordination was rewarded 8 years later when the monastery allowed him to become a Dominican brother. From age 34 until his death at 59, De Porres was in charge of the infirmary where he administered care to his patients without regard for social status, believing everyone to be equal as children of God, a belief ironically not ratified by the laws of colonial society or the church. By the time he died, he was so loved that the entire population of Lima was said to have attended his funeral. Statues and paintings of San Martin de Porres are seen all across Peru, from grand basilicas to people's homes. Every year in the Lima Cathedral, there is a special 40-day festival in dedication to San Martin de Porres, beginning with a feast on November 3rd, and ending with a procession on his birthday, December 9th. In Puerto Rico, the Dominican Republic, and Cuba, San Martin is known as Papa Candelo.